Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Pharmacognosy 2 lecture. And we are on the same topic as yesterday we discussed about flavonoids. And today we'll be concluding this flavonoid part, and we'll be moving ahead with the flavonoid drugs. So little bit we're going to go back. Let us have the a rewind of this what we have studied. So what we have studied till now, that flavonoids are bicutaneous group of naturally ubiquitinous group of naturally occurring phenolic compound characterized by flavin nucleus and represents on the one of the most prevalent class of compound in fruits, vegetable, plant derived beverages. Okay, सबसे ज्यादा पाए जाने वाले naturally occurring polyphenols हैं. More than 8,000 compounds with flavonoid structures have been identified, many of which are responsible for the attractive color of flowers, fruits and leaves. In plants, these compounds offer protection against ultraviolet radiation, pathogens and herbivores. And we have already know that the color of the fruit and the flowers are just because of it contains flavonoids. Okay, classification. Flavonoids occur in both in free and glycoside state. Aglycan part of flavonoid consists of benzene ring condensed with six-membered ring, which is two-position carrier of vinyl ring as a substituent. So this is the aglycan part of flavonoid, and the glycan part is mostly rhamnose, galactose. Flavonoids are characterized by C6 structure. This is how we characterize flavonoids. We have already discussed this. I'm just going brief about this topic. Structurally, flavonoid can be classified according to benzopyrone saturation and different substitution in the ring. The flavonoids are characterized into flavones, catechin, flavonones, anthocyanidins, and isoflavonoids. The structure of major classes are flavonoids are classified as flavones, and which in the examples are quercetin, camphorol, myrcetin, flavones, luteolin, epigen, flavonones, hertzpyridine, flavonoid glycoside, astragalin, rutin, flavonol, lignans, silibinins, isoflavonol, diazidins, gencitins, anthocyanidin, cyanidins, or orons, leptosidin, urocidins, leucoanthocyanidins, teracidins, teracasidin, neoflavonoids, cortaregin. Okay, so these are the classification of glycoside. Among this, we have already discovered two major classes of glycosides, that are flavonoids and isoflavones, here in the previous lecture. So this is the basic structure of flavonoid. It consists of C6 ring and basic structure of flavonoid. The biologically active flavonoids were first discovered evident by Hugerian farm physiologist Albert Sezant in the year 1938. He reported the citrus peel flavored having a preventive action against capillary bleeding and fragility. So he was the first scientist who identified evidenced the existence of flavonoid in the year 1838. And just because what he saw that the citrus peel contains the protective action against capillary bleeding. Flavonoids have both broad spectrum of biological activity. They have shown to exert antimicrobial, antiviral, anti-atherosclerosis, cardioprotective, anti-urogenic, anti-neoplastic, mutagenic, anti-diabetic, anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, anti-aging, anti-hepatotoxic, anti-hypertensive, hypolipidemic, and anti-platelet activity. So these are the activities which a flavonoid consists of. Pharmacological action. Flavonoids have been reported to have wide range of pharmacobiological activities. It includes antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, anti-cancer, cardioprotective, hepatoprotective, antimicrobial, antiviral, anti-allergic, vasodilatory, and also in treatment of neurodegenerative diseases. They were reported to inhibit various enzymes like hydrolyrolidase, lipase, alkaline phosphatase, CAMP phosphodiesterase, alpha glucosidase, and kinase. See, so this is the pharmacological activity of flavonoids, and this is the lay chart which indicates the different action of flavonoids as antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, phytoprotective. When we say it act on our CNS, so it gives us sedative effect, anxiolytic effect, anticonvulsant effect, antidepressant effect, antiparkinson's effect, neuroprotective effect. Okay, so this shows that how flavonoids are important, and this shows that how much we get from flavonoids as when we as a pharmacological action. Metabolism of flavonoids. So once we consume flavonoids, since in a large amount in our dietary source, we consume in flavonoids. In fruit, we get flavonoids. In vegetables, we are getting flavonoids. And in colorful things, whatever we eat, we get flavonoids. And in the polished, unpolished pulses we eat, we get flavonoids. So then in a many dietary content, we get in flavonoids. Okay, so how does this metabolize in the body? And how it is available for us to show different type of action. Basically, we consider the flavonoid, most of its properties being used just because it has a potent antioxidant activity. Okay. Many dietary flavonoids occur in O-glycosides. So I have already told that glycoside may exist in a form free state or in the combined state with glycosides. Okay. So when it is in glycoside state, it contains a glycon part with a glycone part. And when these two parts are combined together, when a glycone and a glycone are bridged together, when they are joined together, so there is a sort of linkage. That is what is called as glycosidal linkage. And when there is a glycoside linkage of oxygen, so we call it an O-glycoside. Okay. So when it is a glycoside linkage of C, so we call it a C-glycoside. When it is a D, so we call it D, S, N, okay. So sorry, by mistake I said D, where it is S or N, sulfur, nitrogen, oxygen, carbon. So depending upon the type of linkage between the glycon and the A-glycon portion. The common glycoside are glucose. So when we say the type of glycon moiety attached with the glycoside, attached with the flavonoid is glucose, galactose, arbinose, rhamnose. Okay, so this is the glycon portion when we have the glycoside combined with flavonoid. Okay. The presence of sugar moiety resists the beta hydrolysis by pancreatic enzymes. So the presence, when it occur in the glycoside stage, when it occur in the combination with the glycoside, so the sugar moiety plays a role of inhibiting, resisting the hydrolysis by pancreatic enzyme. 2-beta endoglycosidase is a small intestine capable of flavonoid glycoside hydrolysis. So this is the enzyme which is present in the small intestine, which is capable of hydrolyzing glycoside in small intestine. Lactase, pyrrolizidine, hydrolase, and non-specific cytosolic enzyme are reported to deglycosate flavonoids and allow for conjugation reaction. Okay, so lactase, fluorosilicin, hydrolase, and non-specific cytosolic enzymes are responsible for its the deglycosate flavonoids to break down it and allow it to for conjugation reaction. The bioavailability of flavonoid vary with the location structure of sugar moiety in the flavonoids. Bioavailability, how it is going to be available depending upon the location where it is and the type of sugar moiety attached with it. Absorption depends upon the dosage, diet, sex differences and the microbial population, the colon. So this is the how the absorption can take place, which depends on number of factors, how much you are intake, what kind of dose you are taking of flavonoid, how you are getting into what form you are taking that flavonoid, that depends on the diet and sex differences, male and female, and particularly the microbial population in the colon. Liver play a major role in the absorption of flavonoids, that is absorbed in small intestine, then in colon. Okay, metabolism of flavonoid depend upon the gut flora. The pyrrole ring in the flavonoid is cleaved by microflora. The pyrrole ring found in the flavonoid is basically cleaved with the help of microflora, resulting in the formation of phenylacetic acid and phenylpropionic acid and inert byproduct. Okay. So when these flora act on the pyrrole ring, it results jo breakdown hota hai, it gives different compound. Basically, yesterday in the class itself, we have seen that when we go for structure elucidation, or we have to find out whether it contains the pyrrole ring or not. We have already studied with water hydrolysis. We're going to get two different compounds. One, we're going to get a benzene ring and an acetic acid ring. Okay. phenyl ring and acetic benzene ring. Okay, so this is how when the flavonoid get break down in the small intestine, it will get break down by the help of so this result in the formation of phenyl acetic acid. That means flavonoid is going to break down and it going to give a byproduct, that is phenyl acetic acid and phenyl propionic acid, and inert then number of inert byproducts we are going to get. Okay, during the phenyl ring breakage, the sugar moiety of flavonoid will be removed by microflora and result in aglycone moiety of flavonoid that can easily penetrate through the intestinal wall. तो जब ये पैरोन रिंग का ब्रेकडाउन होता है तो उसमें जब वो ब्रेकडाउन हो रहा है तो शुगर मॉइटी जो फ्लेवोनॉइड में पाई जाती है वो हमारे माइक्रोफ्लोरा रिमूव कर देते हैं, कंजर्व कर लेंगे, और जो एक लाइकन मॉटी है वो हमारी फ्लेवोनॉइड की जो फ्लेवोनॉइड है ना, वो हमारे इजिली हम पेनिट्रेट इन टू अवर इंटेस्टाइनल वॉल, हमारे इंटेस्टाइनल वॉल में पेनिट्रेट हो जाएगा. एचपीएलसी टेक्निक इज एनालिसिस ऑफ फ्लेवोनॉइड इन यूरिन एंड फीसेस प्रोवाइड एविडेंस ऑफ मिथाइलेशन, हाइड्रोक्सिलेशन, ओ मिथाइलेशन, सल्फेशन, glucuronation, which occur as a byproduct primarily of liver and intestine microbial formation, है ना. तो अगर हम इस सैंपल के एनालिसिस करते हैं तो हमें पता चलेगा कि क्या क्या how what occurs when the primarily liver के अंदर जब हमारा breakdown हो रहा है, microbial transformation हो रहा है, तो what are the steps occurring? HPLC, high performance liquid chromatography of these flavonoid when get absorbed in the body can be done and you will get this type of result. Okay, so what is what we हमने क्या जाना भी? ये जाना कि जब sugar का जब pyrrole ring breakdown हो रही है तो उस वक्त में जो flavonoid है, aglycone part है, वो flavonoid को हमारे intestinal wall के through penetrate होके चले जाएगा. Okay, so this was about your flavonoid. And I'm starting with the very first drug of flavonoid, that is tea. Okay, so we have three drugs. Okay, so I'm starting with the pharmacognosy of tea. It contains a prepared leaf of tea buds of Tea sinensis belonging to family Thiaceae, biological source. Okay, geographical source, it mainly cultivated in India and Assam, Ceylon, Japan and Java. Cultivation collection, it is an evergreen shrub growing to 4 meters by 2.5 meters at a slow rate. The plant prefers light and medium soil and requires well-drained soil. Okay, that's why tea it's mainly planted at the hill station because of it, it can easily avoid clogging of water, and tea plantation is generally done at step farming. Okay. The plant prefers acid neutral soil and can grow in very acidic soil. It grows in semi shade. It requires moist soil, prefer at pH between 5 to 7. The prefers a partial shade of light wood sand land and woodland clearing. It reported to tolerate annual rainfall of 70 to 310 centimeters and average, prefers at wet summers and annual temperature about 14 to 27 degrees Celsius and pH range 4.5 to 7.3. It prefers a wet summer and a cool but not very frosty and dry winters. Seed can be sown as soon as it is ripe in greenhouse. Stored seed should be pre-soaked for 24 hours in warm water and the hard covering and the micro pile should be piled down to leave the thin covering. So when you get the premature seed, the seed has to be stored in, and before sowing, it should be soaked in water, warm water, and uske upar ka micro covering hai, usko nikal dena hai, aur thin covering rahe leaf seed paper. It is usually germinated in 1 or 2-3 months. Prick out the seedling into an individual pot. When they are large enough to handle and grow them on the light shade in the greenhouse for like this first winter, plant them out into their permanent position when they are more than 15 centimeter tall and give them some protection from winter cold for their first year and three outdoors. Seedlings take 4 to 12 years before they start to produce seed. Okay, characteristic of the tea leaves. Morphology, leaves are dark green color, lenticular shape, the shape of the leaf is like lens, like your eyes. And elliptical is when the both the apex and the base are little narrow, and it is little broader at the mid part. So it's called elliptical shape. It has a blunt apex. The like unlike other leaves, like your vinca leaf, it doesn't have any sharp apex, or nor it is not going to have a pricking apex, or a blunt apex. Base is tapering, taper base. towards the margin, towards the pedicel of the leaf. Shortly serrate. Serrate is the margins. When there is a small cut in the margin of the leaf, that is called serrate margin. So they are shortly serrate. Young leaves are hairy. Hairy means that contains trichomes. Older leaves are glabrous. So only when the leaves are grown, the leaves are glabrous. Microscopy, the epidermal cells are made up of polygonal cells which are slightly wavy. Wall, it consists of itself stomata, trichomes. Trichomes are thick walled, unicellular. So that, as I said, young leaves are hairy just because it contains trichomes. And trichomes here in the tea leaves are little thick walled, unicellular, conical, which rise at the on the lower surface of the larger membrane of the leaves. Mesophyll region consists of two rows of pellicet cells. Pellicet cell, as you all know, that the number of cells beneath each epidermal cell, they are pellicet cell, and it contains lignified sclerites, which arise at the same interval in the and extend across the mesophylls from one epidermis to other. You can see clusters of calcium oxalate in the phloem and the parenchyma. In the midrib area, there is a prominent ridge in the upper and below part of the leaf. Vascular bundle consists of xylem, phloem, and present. The entire region being covered by slightly lignified band of pericytic fibers. So this is about the microscopy of tea leaves. Chemical constituent: tea is a rich source of caffeine. It contains theobromine, theophylline, major quantities. The color of tea is due to tannin, and that is galactotannic acid, which is 10 to 20%. So when you prepare tea, you get a color just because of galactotannic acid, which is 10 to 20%. Apart from this, it contains 1 to 5% of caffeine, which majorly and it also contains theobromine, theophylline, minor quantities. Agreeable odor due to presence of yellow volatile oil. So the agreeable odor of tea is just because of contain volatile oil. Tea also contain protein, wax, resins, and ash. So this is the structure of caffeine, theobromine, chemical test. Alkaloid, other pure alkaloid gives myriside color reactions. So this is the alkaloidal test. Caffeine, take caffeine in petri dish to which hydrochloric acid and potassium chlorate are added, treated with dryness. Purple color is obtained on exposing to vapors of dilute ammonia. In addition, fixed alkali, the purple color disappears. In addition to fixed alkali, purple color will go. Caffeine also produces white precipitate with tannic acid solution. Use it. It is used as stimulant, astringent, also as diuretic. Since we are studying this drug as a flavonoid drug, so what tea contains? Teas are rich in antioxidant phenols because it contains catechin, flavonols, theophyllines, and thioarubergins. Epidemiology evidence relating a regular consumption of tea or related polyphenols to congestive heart disease is equivocal. Catechin are absorbed from the tea, but low plasma concentration are attained. So, since tea is considered a flavonoid drug, so what it contains? It contains number of flavonoid ligands named as catechin, flavonols, theophylline, and thioarubin. And it is reported to have a very good result on congestive heart diseases, but not the tea what we consume, black tea. It is a very good cardiovascular drug when you take green tea. Okay, the bioavailability of the theophylline and thioarubin is unknown. The tea does not reduce blood pressure, plasma lipid, or plasma lipid in well-controlled human trials. देखा गया है कि टी कोई हमारा ब्लड प्रेशर रिड्यूस नहीं करती है, ना ही वो हमारा लिपिड प्लाज्मा लेवल कंट्रोल कर रही है इन केस ऑफ ह्यूमन ट्रायल्स. द प्लाज्मा एंटीऑक्सिडेंट पोटेंशियल आफ्टर ड्रिंकिंग ग्रीन टी बट नॉट ब्लैक टी. ओके, पॉली बट इट इनहिबिट्स एलडीएल लिपिड परऑक्सीडेशन विट्रो एंड इफेक्ट एक्स इन विवो इन स्मॉल. ओके, सो बट इट इनहिबिट्स एलडीएल लिपिड, दैट एलडीएल इज लो डेंसिटी लिपिड्स इन लिपिड परऑक्सीडेशन. Okay, tea consumption tended to reduce the development of aortic atherosclerosis in rabbit. Tea polyphenols exerted marked effect on cell and inhibit neutrophil migration and inflammatory responses, sometimes to low at low concentration as well. So this was all about flavonoid today, and I'm completing this flavonoid topic today with this. But we will continue with the drugs of the other categories. We are going to continue with the drugs of this category. Okay. Thank you for joining today, and have a good day.